synthesized in the industry or no any other chemical which is taken from here and there. Only those chemicals which are synthesized by the nature, by the plants. And these plants extracts have been used in a particular ratio at a particular laboratory condition. And these extracts through a very simple process, we have made their extracts, crushing and all, and we have taken out and filtered and all. And no alcohol or nothing or other some chemical were added into this. And we were surprised to see that these organic sanitizers, the meaning is that since only the phytochemicals which are synthesized by the nature are used for formulation of these organic sanitizers, so they are 100% safe. Another important point is this, that they have very, very high energy. They are high surface energy liquids. They can enter anywhere in the cavity of the fruits or vegetable. It is seen here that these molecules, these organic sanitizer, they are 100% nano emulsion, or in fact, we will say they develop the nano hydration spheres. They have high kinetic energy, high surface area, entropy. At the same time, the beauty of this organic sanitizer is this, that it has least activation energy. In general, whenever surface thing, any sanitizer is applied, it activates the activation energy, and that surface becomes also involved in the chemical process. So this, because it is already having constructive entropy and surface high surface area, so it could easily approach the dust particle or coronavirus or some other things which is sticking on the surface, and can, the fundamental mechanism is to, number one, to wet out. It wets out the surfaces. After wetting it out, it then initiate the washing. Wetting the surface, then at the same time, simultaneously, the washing starts, or detaching of the surface starts. So the picture here is geraniol is here, which is again is a present a phytochemical and present in the citrus family. It acts as a molecular tweezer because it is monodispersed in the organic sanitizer, and its structural constituents, they can easily approach and come closer to the coronavirus protein and RNA. So it tweezes out. It develop a mechanism where that is detached, succumbent, and then what happens that whenever we wash the fruits and veggies with this organic sanitizer, then since it is biocompatible, so safe and also perfectly washes out the corona virus or pesticide or other things. So this is overall this thing. Now, the fundamental point, as I have told, that until unless the sanitizing molecules and the coronavirus, they come at a working distance, till then nothing will happen. So this picture highlights that they come, this, as I told you, that it wets the surfaces. Wetting the surfaces means it is approaching near to the molecule. It is a real molecule. It has surface energy. It has surface forces. So when this organic sanitizer approaches the surface wherever it is attached, it comes at a working place. So interaction starts in a very infinitesimal mode. This interaction is not started in a very deeper way, otherwise surface will also be damaged. So the fundamental concept of this science is this, that Lennard-Jones potential distance is workable, because these two, the linkage between the organic sanitizer or the molecule which is sanitizing, or the phytochemicals which are responsible and which are monodispersed in the water, they reach to the corona and they interact. And this is a potential energy. Once this potential energy, and not very, very high potential well, but at a workable, so we say that now this organic sanitizer starts functioning. And definitely it will denature the protein. We know very well that proteins are dissolved in the water, and especially when phytochemicals are present. So This is 100% safe, that when these phytochemicals are present in the organic sanitizer, they will definitely, they have hydrophobicity, hydrophilicity, protein also hydrophobic in nature, entropic. The protein unfolding is fundamentally an entropic process. So entropy is already there, movements are already there, molecular motions are already there, they're coordinated. When they're coordinated, they're optimized. This optimization is a process where the corona will be defunct. So this is the fundamental science of this organic sanitizer. We have a look at this picture. As I told you, that both are coming, there are two interfaces. So we will say that there should be the least interfacial energy between these two, between the organic sanitizer, sanitizing molecules and the surfaces. So it's, if it is least or minimum, there is an excellent wetting and there's an excellent washing or there's an excellent detaching of the coronavirus. See, in this picture, there are two types of the surfaces. Where the uniform surfaces, where no corona, no any dust or pesticides attest. So wetting and washing is a uniform. But whenever the unknown entity is attached on the surface, corona or something else, then the different mode. So this also acts as an indicator. Whenever we use this, then its potential energy, its entropy, and its wettability changes. So this picture is here, the fundamental properties of this. And this behaves like a Newtonian fluids in the sense that it is highly stable. Thermodynamically, kinetically, the organic sanitizer highly stable because in between, no structural change. Once the organic sanitizer is developed, then its molecules remain monodispersed. They do not aggregate, they do not cluster, because clustering and aggregation again defunct the washing and wetting abilities of the sanitizing molecules. So therefore, this proves that this organic sanitizer is a Newtonian fluid because it does not degrade, does not undergo structural change with time. It remains constant. So we know very well that see, when we talk about phytochemicals, without oil, we cannot survive. And beta carotene, the picture is here. So these are very remarkable molecular teasers, which is inducing the wettability and the washing capability, and also at the same time, reducing the interfacial tension or interfacial energy between the skin of the fruit and the sanitizer. They come at a very, very closest distance so that the dust particle, corona, could safely go away. So that's why, and already as I told you, they are biocompatible. So because these organic sanitizers, they are made up of phytochemicals only, plants and vegetables and other, they have phytochemicals. So biocompatibility wise, this is excellent. Stability wise, also excellent. I have already explained. Now, if we see, as I was taking, that it is a monodisperse. Monodisperse means it has ability to move on the surfaces, to come closer to the coronavirus. So if we have this picture, then the molecules are completely monodispersed. The picture is here. We have conducted the experiments that antioxidants or polyphenols we have taken from plants, and we wanted to dissolve. In general, polyphenols are not dissolved in water, so we have tried to add certain phytochemicals and develop the nanoemulsion of this. Then in this nanoemulsion, all the polyphenols which we wanted to dissolve, they were dissolved. So, and we have applied this on the fruits and the veggie surfaces. That was also clean because the concept and the purpose, the fundamental science of this, that there it develops the least interfacial energy between the two surfaces. The sanitizer molecules, they have their own surfaces also. Similarly, the fruits and vegetables, they have their own surfaces. So question is that the dialogue will start when they will come very close to each other. So in this concept, it is a novel, it is a remarkable sanitizer which is formulated by the phytochemicals. Another important point, that when the molecules are in the organic sanitizer, they are monodispersed. It means the potential or the surface is zeta potential. and charges, they align on the surface. This alignment of the charges on the surfaces again gives an additional activity or additional potential to the organic sanitizer to wash out, to denature that virus which is sticking on the surfaces. So this is a very fundamental science. The monodisperse does not mean only wetting, but it also structurally aligns the surface forces of the molecules. We know very well zeta potential. So this zeta potential becomes very functional. It is not very high, it is optimum. So that is workable. Similarly, as I told you, conventional sanitizers that damage the surfaces. I take the example of sodium hypochlorite. It is corrosive. Not only this, but we know very well ClO. It's a CFC, chlorofluorohydrocarbon, they also develop. So there is a possibility that, of course, this ClO, whenever it comes in contact with already dissolved water, it develops HOCl. So this is acid and it corrodes. Sodium also binds the water. So ultimately, this conventional or sodium hypochlorite is not advisable sanitizer, but for centuries it is being used because no research is being conducted in this area. And we have 70% ethanol. We found it safe. No, but it is not safe. Since it has 70% amount, it develops stronger or higher osmotic pressure. So whenever it is applied, it attracts the water molecules. So it causes dehydration. Even on the skin, if it is applied on the skin, it can dehydrate. We may not find this effect, but later on with time, it could be seen. So these demerits are removed by developing an organic sanitizer. This is based neither on the ionic hydration nor on the osmotic pressure or this concept, but it is devised based on the nano hydration spheres. Small. So charge zeta potential is also neutralized and molecule remains monodisperse. They have also very, very least interfacial energy. So they have high kinetic energy and high entropy. These two fundamental properties, they lead this sanitizing molecule to the surfaces of the corona whenever it is attached, especially the waggies and the fruits. So it becomes an asset in the hands of the in the kitchen that it's safe, biocompatible and everything. Similarly, if we see that as I told you that eugenol in clove and the fundamental this monoterpene and limonene, citrus and many others also we see multi. So what happens since in this organic sanitizer, many phytochemicals are present in the nanohydration form. So they develop multiple energy pockets. These multiple energy pockets are not of the same energy. So there is a spontaneity in the organic sanitizer. It is active, but at the same time, it does not aggregate. It does not cluster. So this is a remarkable and novel science of this, that it is also having different energy pockets with different entropy. So it has a competition to go to the surfaces wherever this organic sanitizer is present as per Le Chatelier law. So this organic sanitizer, energy-wise, entropy-wise, potential-wise, wettability-wise, washing-wise, compatibility, biocompatibility-wise, it is a remarkable concept. And also safety. So there's no question of having doubt and no question of formulation also, because we do not take any chemical which is synthesized in the industry. Only plant chemicals, phytochemicals, which are synthesized by the plants like menta and so many others. So that's why this concept seems very valid and it is working very well also. Surface area is very high. Now, as I told you that this is an ideal picture here, potential energy of same size. But our sanitizer, organic sanitizer, because varieties of phytochemicals are present, they have different structure. SAR, structure activity relationship, also thermodynamic relationship. So because of these things, this potential energy is not one. Had there been one potential energy, there is a perfect equilibrium. So our this organic sanitizes away from equilibrium. I will not say that it is irreversible thermodynamics, but of course, in case of killing, in case of detaching, in case of washing, and in case of wetting out the corona surfaces, it is irreversible. But in case of this energy wise, when it is stored or kept, it is not this that only one kind of energy is present. Brownian motions. And Brownian motions, they have very high kinetic energy, and they look for the vacant surfaces. They identify the surfaces also. We know very well that oil paints from these oil or limonene and all, they are used for stripping the paints. So similarly, and paints is very strongly bound on the solid surfaces. Similarly, these phytochemicals in our organic sanitizer, they are a remarkable science to ensure complete killing, complete removal of the coronavirus. Now, this is, as I told you, because varieties of structures are present in the organic sanitizer, and there is a fluid dynamics whenever it is moving on the surfaces, because it is not a static, it is a kinetic, it is a dynamic process. The application of organic sanitizer is a kinetic process, it's a dynamic process. It has to wet out, it has to move from one location to another location. In this process, the dust particles or the coronavirus, whenever it is attached, their colonies are also not of the same dimension. So it develops entangles. Our organic sanitizer entangles the corona virus, and because the coronavirus of not same size, so there is a fluid dynamics, means different energy or different entanglement occurs. This difference in entanglement becomes an inbuilt potential to remove, because again a spontaneity will be developed somewhere, least energy, somewhere high kinetic energy. So the process will start to equilibrate. In this process, automatically we take the mileage, we take this intra mechanism potential or spontaneity, we take the mileage of it to remove the coronavirus from the surfaces of the fruits and the baggies, because we have to dissolve this, or we have to put into the organic sanitizer solution. So for some time, so automatically these fluid dynamics starts working. Similarly, as I told you, wettability, highest wettability only possible when it is monodispersed. So this monodispersion is having the least cohesive forces, and if it is clustered, then it is having highest cohesive forces. It defuncts automatically. I told that organic sanitizer, it is not aggregated, it is not clustered. Had it been aggregated, then again surface energy decreased and size also decreased. So there is no question of its applicability, because it becomes a bulk material. It is not a functional material. So ultimately the functionality, because it remains monodispersed in the aqueous solution, that's why it is remarkable. As I told you, no alcohol is added, no any other chemical is added, disinfectant added. They have the inbuilt characteristics. So this inbuilt characteristics of the corona, of our organic sanitizer, perfectly removes the coronavirus from the surfaces. Now, since this is monodispersed, it develops a stretching frequencies. It develops the molecular motions, the twisting. It has to reach to the with the energy. This organic sanitizer molecules, they should reach to the coronavirus with certain kinetic energy and stretching, so that it can surround, it can cut off the relation of this coronavirus from the surfaces. So this concept where this molecule is it starts developing the stretching and molecular motions, so that the twisting or the constituents of the organic sanitizer could reach to the right place and could detach the coronavirus. So this is the fundamental science, and this is simple thing. It has to it should not go fastly. If it is like a volatile, then it will not be able to establish the contact. So shear rate should be moderate, could not fastly go. Shear rate of this organic sanitizer on the solid surface or the fruits and vegetables, it should go with time so that wetting and washing simultaneously can occur and can ensure can also reach to the micro cavities of the fruits on the skin. Similarly, if we see the beauty of this sanitizer, this lady finger, a continuous thin film is developed. There is no any gap. So wherever there are micro cavities and there is a possibility that the corona could stay here or could stick here, it is completely gone because it cut off its relation from the environment also and completely surround. So there are few that vegetables here and the fruits. Now, if we see the banana, it is making a continuous thin film. There is no any bubble type structure. Had there been bubble type structure, it means aggregation. And when there are aggregation, but here it is a completely kind of a caging. So it cages the thin film of developed by the coronavirus on the fruits and the vegetables, it makes a kind of caging. Then process washing and detaching action, denaturing of the protein and RNA interact with this, so they start. Now, I have seen there's a very natural old thing that the lotus automatically clean, because it automatically clean in the sense that there is water drops comes, juice. So this water of particular size, they develop cohesive force, and cohesive force means it helps in rolling. So it also moves ahead. When it moves ahead, it has certain surface forces. So it dissolves the dust particles or corona or other thing. This mechanism, this is very, very popular in the Roman paganism. They found that there is some supernatural power to keep in the lotus, but the fundamental science is fricosity, because it has adequate size of the water molecules, append and drop, it rolls. When it rolls, it is having surface charge or surface energy also. The surface energy interacts with the dust particle that is sticking on the lotus leaf. So सर देखिए, सो सॉरी फॉर इंटरप्शन. सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग दैट देयर आर वेरी फाइन माइक्रो कैविटीज वेयर द कोरोना वायरस पेस्टिसाइड अदर थिंग गेट स्टक. एंड इफ वी टेक एनी ऑर्डिनरी सैनिटाइजर बिकॉज इट डज नॉट हैव एडिक्वेट थर्मोडायनेमिक पैरामीटर्स लाइक एंट्रोपी एंड काइनेटिक एनर्जी एंड लीस्ट सरफेस एरिया, सो इट कुड नॉट एंटर. दो वी थिंक दैट इट इज वास्ट, बट इट इज नॉट वास्ट प्रैक्टिकली. It is practically not vast, so it is seen here that we have to see that any sanitizer is fundamentally, especially the organic sanitizer, because it has highest energy, highest entropy, and highest kinetic energy, surface area. Even it enters in the micro capillaries of the fruits and vegetables, where there's a possibility of sticking of the coronavirus or the pesticide or some other undesired dust particles. So in that way, it also ensures fundamentally that the basic concept of mono dispersion, larger surface area of the sanitizing or molecular tissues of the organic sanitizers, they ensure the removal, complete removal of the coronavirus from even from the micro capillaries of the fruits. This picture here is that when a higher water strider, cohesive energy of your sanitizer is very high, then it will not move to, or it will not wash out, or it will not wet out the surfaces. The picture is left hand side is given here. The water drop is stable because it is developing a stronger cohesive forces and it is not able to completely wash. There are gaps in between. So in these gaps, corona could stick easily. So now there is a error that whenever we are developing our organic sanitizer, there's a question, this completely mono dispersed, no question of highest cohesive forces, in fact zero cohesive forces, all cohesive forces are converted into the kinetic energy. So water strider cannot walk on such organic sanitizer. In this, in the picture, nanoparticle, they are completely distributed because they have adequate kinetic energy. So our organic sanitizer could easily distribute to micro capillaries where no virus or something could remain stick because it flush out them and it wets out the surface. In search of wetting out the surface of the veggies and the fruits, it moves, it enters. And then ultimately, the corona has to come out. Now, there's a very interesting picture here. Everyone is taking tea. It's not any unique, but of course, science depends on the observation. Observations is someone is having very keen observation, extraordinary eyes, extraordinary thinking, then it definitely leads to extraordinary vision. So we see here that when tea was prepared with the simple milk and tea leaf roasted and sugar. So it was, we have seen that casein and fat, they were floating, they were aggregated. So they were aggregated means there are also spaces. So in this spaces, anything can enter, corona virus could go shelter because there is an empty space. And it is possible, it is only done because formulation of this tea is not proper. And it is making similarly, it could also happen to the fruit skins. So there is a need of caution that if you wash your veggies and the fruits, you should not wash with the sanitizer which is having this like structure aggregates, because rather than removing, it will invite the coronavirus in between the empty gaps. These empty gaps, adequate moisture and others, so they will harbor. Now, if we see the picture below, we have added clove, ginger, black pepper, other things, very surprising result. The casein is dispersed, the fat is dispersed, there is no any aggregation. It is having highest kinetic energy. Even if you take such tea or such organic sanitizer, this will also wash out, this will also dissolve the fat which is deposited in the body, because it has adequate kinetic energy, it has adequate entropy, it has thermodynamic stability and kinetic stability. So this will not aggregate, this will remain monodispersed, and this monodispersion of the organic sanitizing or molecules of phytochemicals is a fundamental science for cleaning the veggies and the fruits. So this is an example before us, a practical, not example, a practical, that these phytochemicals, they are dispersing. They are also dispersed. Fat is not removed in both the cases, but fat is gone. It is monodispersed. So in fact, it is a very remarkable situation that if we take tea with the phytochemicals like clove and all, then it is a very remarkable, it gives also energy because it is having, it needs least activation energy. But if you take the tea which is prepared with the aggregated, then for dispersion ultimately in the body, it is to be dispersed. It needs additional energy from the our body. More and more ATPs will be utilized. So really, if we want to save our ATPs for successful work rather than for removing this aggregated or dispersing these aggregates, we have prepared tea this outside. So this is the basic concept of the organic sanitizer, that it does not have any aggregated form of any phytochemical. And this is the only region that it can enter. It can only penetrate the cell of the corona, membrane, cell membrane of the corona. It is having hydrophobicity, hydrophilicity, lipid bilayers, where this phosphatidylcholine and others, they are making this structure. So this can, because of the compatibility, organic sanitizer could also enter the cell of the coronavirus. Now this is again a very remarkable picture. That's whenever we are washing this thing, since it is having protein spike and it sticks, could stick, there's a possibility on this could stick on the surfaces. I have already explained that our sanitizer, organic sanitizer, is also having the monodispersion of the sanitizing phytochemicals. They enter in between this, as I told you, that there is no gap. So this gap becomes an asset and a potential for our organic sanitizer to defunct the coronavirus. Wherever these gaps are there, it will enter and it will denature, it will defunct its contact, it will detach, it will weaken its contact with the veggies and the fruit surfaces. So our organic sanitizer is automatically this making the best use of this protein spikes of the coronavirus, because an empty spaces, in fact, it was wetting out, washing the ordinary surfaces, but here empty spaces are already available. So this becomes truly an asset, a fundamental compatibility, a some fundamental suitability of the organic sanitizer to specifically defunct the coronavirus. So this is a remarkable, this is a microfluidics that they are entering. Microfluidics or fricofluidics is entering its cavities. So we have seen that even if it is not going with this, we can simply apply a small magnetic field, magnet Weber or Tesla. So this could also be a possibility that it could denature the coronavirus protein. We have seen that this particular set of science is called magnetorheological fluids. It develops a rheology by the magnetic field that it washes out, it enters the electrostatic charges of the coronavirus protein or even other protein. And we have seen this, the pepsin, peptone, and egg albumin, there's a change. So this is also the best way to make the use of the magnetorheological fluid. It is not added in the mixture, it is applied from outside. And sorting out proteins, we can our organic sanitizer is already low energy, so protein could be also dissolved, easily dissolved, and could be removed. Similarly, the DNA, RNA, because it can easily intercalate the DNA, but since RNA is a single stranded structure, so this and the phosphate group, where electrostatic oxygen atoms are there, So our phytochemicals almost have the similar structure. There's a compatibility again action in the reaction, in the action mechanism, there's a compatibility. So it becomes also fundamental science. So we are having here that organic sanitizer is an asset. Structurally, thermodynamically, and activity-wise, and interfacial energy remarkable charges which have come. So charges also, because in the last slide, I've told when there's a high surface energy liquid, then these charges align, and this our organic sanitizer already in the monodisperse, it is a suitable situation to kill the virus. Now, as I told you, the microfluidics, it enters. We have conducted this small experiment that let us see what happens in small capillaries. So this automatically we have taken that orange peel and its structure, and we have dried and the fresh. So we try to see the electricity, because this microfluidics automatically, because capillaries are fine, if it is not moved ahead, we can apply a small current. So that current now catalyzes. So we have seen that it was dry, microfluidics means in the capillaries, it was going, plants, roots are also microfluidics. Our veins and arteries, they are also microfluidics. Their structure very fine and very thin. So we have seen that when the fresh that peel was taken and connected with this electric device, then multimeter, it passed the current, there's a continuity. And it flowed. Why it flowed? Because it is continuity and flowing from one point to another point, the source and the sink. Similarly, when we have taken the dried peel and tried to connect this, there was no connectivity, no current was flown. This proves that our organic sanitizer is a remarkable wetting agent, a washing agent. It's a dynamic, it's not a static, it is a kinetic in the nature. So these structures become remarkable, and in fact microfluidics, which is a very great rescue for surrounding and defuncting the coronavirus. And we have seen this see not the excellent way, because water is having least surface energy and making the drops, large size droplets, no question of washing. And our this thing, different chemicals are here. So these chemicals, phytochemicals, they are making it monodisperse, and they can, as I told you, not only microcapillaries, but they can also enter the this membrane, lipid bilayer membrane of the virus. So it is also the fundamental science where, and the simple thing that is, because there is a need to measure the interfacial energy, a fundamental principle of this is that when it moves or action mechanism, I was explaining that interfacial energy between these two surfaces should be least. In fact, our organic sanitizer already has a very least interfacial energy, that then only it moves. So it is measured with a simple device. This device is already available in the Borosil catalog. And this is the name of this device, service meter. So it could be used. We have made this thing and washed this before and after. There's a shining. So this proved that our organic sanitizer has entered its microcapillaries, and wherever the dust particle or the corona or the undesired other pesticides, they were sticking on the, because fruits and vegetable cells are living cells, they are not dead cells. So ultimately there's a delicacy how to remove. So organic sanitizer is the only way out, is the only fundamental science, is the only solution to wash out or to remove the coronavirus from the micro capillaries and veggies. So we have seen that it is shining. And because of the low surface energy, it enters. There's no hindrance. Had there been hindrance, it would have not gone ahead and would have not washed the surfaces, and corona could have not come out. So this is loosening the grip of that. So we can easily calculate quantitatively the washing action or corona removal action, simple, either the surface energy in percentage or the frequency in percentage. So these could be calculated, determined by the service meter, and we can easily apply these does organic sanitizer, which is having very least surface energy. In fact, surface meter is also fundamentally helping in formulating the organic sanitizers. If it is high energy, we add certain other stoichiometrically the needed phytochemicals, which further reduce the surface energy. So ultimately, it is the play of the surface energy engineering, which is tracked by the surface meter. So it seems very workable, very effective. And now this corona, I have this thing already, that highest wettability means the surface wettability. So stress and strain, that's shear stress, should also not be like a honey, that it is only at one place. There should be a shear stress, but it should not be like a honey. It should be moderate, where the it could go like and can establish the closest contact with the coronavirus. It should not leave the gaps, as I told, in case of tea prepared with the milk and sugar tea only. So now we have developed this formula. We have measured. We have different these things, plant extracts, this orange peel, zero, and label 1, label 2, label 3, label 4, label 5. We have seen that there is a topography of each surface. Even plants also have topography. This coronavirus has also remarkable topography. So somewhere we are encashing this topography, and we are making the best use the topography of the corona to kill it with the help of organic sanitizer. Because in this gap, in this wherever there's a microcapsule gap, our organic sanitizer is comfortable to move. Had it not moved there, there's no question of defuncting it and wetting it and washing it. But since it is efficiently going, and the size of the molecule in the organic sanitizer, they are also not macro, because phytochemicals of course of larger size, but they are where whichever we the plant extract we have taken, there is a not a big size or not a very small size also, and a moderate one. So this is very remarkable things. Ultimately, it is a molecular interaction engineering which is tracking and defuncting the coronavirus. Now, this thing that we are taking just blindly 70%, this is the graph where the surface energy could be seen, that if it is 0%, then in the water, it is water only. So pure water does not have a strong and efficient washing ability for fruits and vegetables. And we are decreasing, but there is a problem. I told you we cannot wash the fruits and vegetables with the 70% alcohol or ethanol, because it causes dehydration. It takes the water. In fact, there is a stronger bonding between the alcohol and water. So alcohol may also remain and dehydration will be developed. So we have to avoid the use of 70% alcohol or any aqueous ethanol solution to wash the vegetables and the fruits, because it could go to the body and could cause any kind of disease. So we have to avoid that. And in that context, the organic sanitizer, the safer, 100% safer. Now, we have another scene that plants, geraniol, citrus and all, if we make a formulation, this plant extracts. See, very remarkable situation, because the low surface energy is the fundamental science for the action or the action mechanism of the organic sanitizer. So we have seen that when percentage of plant extracts where geraniol is there, then it is drastically decreased. When drastically decreased, it means it is this resultant organic sanitizer is a remarkable sanitizer which could even wash the microcapillaries and the other fine cavities where the corona could take shelter. So in that context, this is a phytochemical. So this proved that it is quantitative determination of the interfacial energy, and We have seen also people were saying that the temperature dependent. So we have seen also that this surface energy temperature dependent, but within that range where it could defunct, and it will be very efficient in washing out or detaching the coronavirus from the surfaces of the baggies and the fluids. So again, it was a very remarkable situation that we have seen this neem leaves and basil leaf flower, basil leaves and menthol leaves and orange peel. And we tried to see their impact because they have remarkable polyphenols and they have remarkable phytochemicals. So we tried to see that we wanted to develop the nanoparticles of the gold because it is also very useful. So we found that it was reduced to the nanoparticle, not only reduced, but it was kept with these phytochemicals. So these phytochemicals again are remarkable thing that in the core there will be a metallic nanoparticle, but outside or function performing that structure is the plant extract of phytochemicals. So it is a very excellent situation where that the phytochemicals also become a rescue and also to wash out the fruits and the vegetables, because ultimately the surface is of phytochemicals, because the metal gold nanoparticle, it is embedded in the core at the center. So working is the done by the this phytochemicals, different phytochemicals. So this is the structure where we have determined, and it found that this different absorption with this different phytochemicals, this proved that yes, the structure exists and this structure is workable, and this workable structure can functionalize any metallic particle for making it a monodisperse and also making it a remarkable this. So now already explained that lipid bilayer, since organic our phytochemicals which are present in this, they are hydrophilic, hydrophobic, so they can easily penetrate, they can easily disrupt also. So for structurally, so hardcore science where we could see that organic sanitizer could go a step ahead. So now, because science goes with the time and science takes sincere efforts to prove anything, definitely, because we already know that antiviral activities, antibacterial activities, all phytochemicals are performing. It's not a new. So this could be also through the penetration of the membrane. Now this structure, because everyone knows that membrane has the potential. So this potential could further be encased. Vegetables and leaf surfaces, they have remarkable potential. And this potential is matched, combated with the surfaces of the organic sanitizer. So it could also be a remarkable synergy. This synergy is to be established. And then once it is established, potential-wise, and it is only possible when organic sanitizer has monodispersion of the phytochemicals or the least surface energy. Otherwise, it will not go. It will make a large size cohesive drops. Then gaps are there. In that gaps, again, any dirt undesired particle could stay. So it is not advisable. Only advisability is that coronavirus, which is having the least energy and also is capable in making the continuous thin film, and this continuous thin film will not leave any gap to this grow for undesired particle, deposition of undesired particle or growth of this coronavirus. So this is a situation where we can extend this hardcore sciences. Now already this explained, because this entropic domain, this is because hydrophilic, hydrophobic, they are not a very static, but it is a, of course, that does not move here and there, but locally it is a enthalpic and also entropic. So these activities are there similar through the weak van der Waals forces, and same activities are already artificially generated in the organic sanitizer. So we found a remarkable synergy. We found a remarkable relationship where this could help in the passage of the selected protein or selected other things to the cell. So this becomes from extracellular fluid to the intracellular fluid. So this becomes a full-fledged science organic now because
can you hear me, sir?
So yes, please.
Can you hear me? Yeah.
Should I continue?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure. Sir, there are several questions before you. From the participants.
My pleasure, madam. My pleasure.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So first of all, I would like to thank all the participants, and I also apologize for the technical glitches that happened during this webinar. But the response has been really encouraging, and there is one very common question that 3 to 4 participants have asked, sir, and that is that there is a normally today we are told that sodium bicarbonate and salt water is generally used to wash off the virus from the vegetables. So how does it do, and could you just shed some light on that, sir?
Ji. Sodium bicarbonate is used, and as I have already explained through the sodium hypochlorite, they are inorganic molecules that generate the ionic species in the solution. Since people think that it has biocompatibility, sodium bicarbonate, it is also used in vegetables. So people think otherwise. If you find that because ions are there, and these ions develop the ionic hydration, in fact they immobilize the water, and in fact they increase the surface energy of the water. But because there is no any suitable option, and there is no, as I told you, the sodium hypochlorite is used since centuries, so there is no research now because of this corona. People are getting awareness about this sanitizer. Otherwise, it is not a very advisable situation. But this organic sanitizer, as I told, because sodium bicarbonate cannot enter the micro cavities where the dust particle, pesticide, or the corona is sitting, because it does not have high energy. It is not a high energy liquid, high surface energy liquid. So it's a wetting power, it's a washing power, and it's a detaching the dust from. It is not so comparable, or not, in fact, because people do not have any option, that's why they start using. Otherwise, organic sanitizer is the best option, because no ionic species, no any inorganic, no any industry synthesized organic compounds are taken, only phytochemicals are taken. So that way, this is the way that sodium bicarbonate is not so advisable, because aqueous solution is aqueous. It is in aqueous added. We know very well hard water does not wash the clothes. Everyone knows why it does not wash the clothes. Washing is same, because it develops the ionic hydration. Along with this, it also develops the stronger Coulombic forces, because charges, when they align the water, positive charge on, suppose you take a cation, then sodium oxygen is attached with the cation outside a hydrogen positive charge, and the reverse, that anion, then it attracts with the hydrogen positive charge and outside negative positive zeta potential very, very high. So it defunct the washing. It is not a best strategy for washing the vegetable and fruits. Please.
Thank you, sir. Sir, there is one more question from Dr. Himanshu Baria. He is asking about how to screen phytochemicals for antiviral properties. And his second part is that how to select phytochemicals for making organic sanitizers.
This is very excellent. Though in my presentation, I have slightly highlighted, the point is this basically, that ultimately, I have been telling that least interfacial energy, that is the only thing that which is making it remarkable. And since this is not an ideal solution, it is a real solution. So along with wetting the surfaces, it washes and it initiates the localized chemical process. So the question is this: we can select the phytochemical in a particular stoichiometry with the vision that it should decrease the surface tension of the water. Ultimately, bulk is water. So we have to measure this with the device which I told you, that interfacial energy or surface energy is to be measured. Suppose I am taking A phytochemical, B phyto, in a particular ratio. Then I have to, formulation means the specific ratio and the property, SAR, surface active structure activity relationship. So that time we have to, it is not like this, it is experimental. So it needs that when you select A, B, C, D, phytochemicals, then make a particular ratio, stoichiometry and synergy also, then at the same simultaneously, please measure the surface energy, whichever least interfacial energy, that is the acid for washing or for formulation of the organic sanitizer. And viral, of course we know, because it, it is very remarkable situation, as I told you, that it has somewhere to different. So it could enter the membrane and could damage the virus structure through protein, through RNA. That's because system is not ideal. They're not like putting a stone together. They are chemically, surface forces are there. I have already zeta, optimum zeta potential. We have intentionally made that surface, it should have surface energy. When highest surface energy, then optimum charges will be aligned on the surfaces. It becomes an asset to kill everything. Please.
Sir, there is one question which is probably of common interest to all the citizens probably. And this is a citizen science seminar. So the question is from Hitesh Kumar Mehta. He asks, what is to be done in case of green vegetables once they get wet and we cannot store it then?
Green vegetables. So I was talking about the green vegetables only, na? So green vegetables, even we can.
Nowadays, when we buy vegetables, there is a trend to, you know, wash them and then store them and before, like, and it is not available in lockdown processes. Obviously, they'll buy for say half 1 week or so. So now, what his question probably is that for green vegetables, if you wash them with this salt water and this thing that is being told to us, so it cannot be stored for longer duration. So is your organic sanitizer a solution for that also, sir?
It is a very, very excellent question. I told you that this organic sanitizer make a continuous thin film. So this continuous and thin film could also be an asset for storing for a longer time. Keep it packed because it is cutting off the exchange, this contact from the skin of the this fruit and veggie and the outside. This continuous thin film. So currently, many people are using, for we know very well that aluminium is not rusted because it makes a automatically thin film by making Al2O3. So that is different. So very good. I will appreciate this question. That now it means we have to little bit tilt our engineering towards a stable, remarkable thin film, so that green vegetable could be stored for a longer time. I salute the person.
Thank you for asking such a question also. Sir, there is another question related to this use of pesticide, and I find it very interesting also, from Nisarg Rathod. And he asked that as today there is great use of pesticides, it may affect the quality of the sanitizer.
Yes. Please, because in my lecture, I have also mentioned, because pesticides, they are a kind of organic molecules. They have very stronger either phosphate or some other. And because they are not degraded whenever they are used. They are not degraded, madam. They are sticking. And when they are sticking on the surfaces, only if they do not stick on the surfaces, there is no question of their absorption. You're getting my point or not? So if we remove at that point only that you wash or you spray, organic spray any rather